This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to a conifer that actually isn't native to Indiana, but has been widely planted across the state in the past, and that's red pine. We can find red pine growing north of Indiana in some of the Lake States areas, typically on sandy, well-drained soils. However, it has been planted extensively in Indiana for windbreaks, erosion control, and a variety of other purposes. Red pine, as you'll notice, has very long needles, much longer than any of our native pines that we've talked about so far. The needles come in clusters of two, as you can see, quite long, and somewhat of a gray-green to, in some cases, yellowish-green color, generally. The needles, if they're bent over, will break cleanly, almost snapping in two like a dry twig. This helps differentiate red pine from another species that's been planted ornamentally in Indiana and looks a lot like it, and that's Austrian pine. However, when the needles on Austrian pine are bent, they do not snap cleanly. You can see that the cone on red pine is a smaller cone and somewhat egg-shaped, and this is a good characteristic for identification as well, about the size and shape of a large chicken egg. Smooth scales on the outer edge. Red pine gets its name because of this rusty, reddish-orangish trunk. So the bark, you can see tones of gray, but kind of dominated by this rusty color. The trees tend to be very straight and tall, making them popular for pulp and timber production in the Lake States. And you can see with those large needles, a very tufted look to the canopies. Red pine can sometimes struggle in Indiana on some of our heavier soils, so it's important if you do plant this species to find places with good drainage and even preferably sandy soils if possible. So not native to Indiana, but found across our state for a variety of plantings, and that's red pine.